Hi guys, and welcome back to another Plan With Me. Today I'll be setting up my other bullet journal, but for the same month. I finally ditched the Victoria's journal and went with this customized notebook that I got from Notability. It's cheaper and the pages are way thicker. But more so about that on my other video that I made for my journals for 2019. I'll be linking it at the upper, at the card at the upper right. So if you want to watch that, just click away. But after this video, okay? To anyone that is concerned about what will happen to my Victoria's journal, no worries about that. I won't be wasting any of those since it's a little expensive for me. I'll be using that for my next year's work bullet journal, so you'll be seeing more of that next year. Now, going back to the Plan With Me, again, my theme for this month is K-pop, specifically BTS. I've become more interested with their music up to the point that that is the one that I've been listening to if I'll be walking to work or going to the gym. It kind of works both ways. Anyways, I started this other journal because I've said before I won't be bringing my iPad with me every day since it's an eyesore for snatchers. I'll be bringing this journal instead and I'll be designing it just like the previous journals setup that I've been doing. I just also want to add in that this isn't my first paper bullet journal. If you've seen my earlier post on Instagram, link below, you would see that I was using a traveler's journal before. At first, I wanted to go back with traveler's journals, but since I've already have this in hand, instead of buying a new one, I'll just make use of this one. So for my cover page, I've decided to make a Dutch door since it became really popular in the journaling community. I mean, so sorry about that. And I wasn't able to do it before on my traveler's journal since it's already half the paper of this one. Well, I could have done it the other way, but anyways, you got my point. This is my first time using it, so I kind of had fun making it the Dutch door. I simply got this photo of theirs from their latest album, as I was told. Or if I'm wrong, let me know in the comments down below. I would love to be educated more about them, but do it nicely, please. Anyways, I got this photo of theirs that it from their album and simply paste it on top of a colored paper, which is a deeper violet, as you can see. So yeah, that's basically it. I paste it in and I added this Miniso white marker on top or on the side of the photo so that it would make a more ripped effect, if that makes sense. Because if you would look at the construction paper, when I ripped off the other side of it, it left a white, the white part, there's a white part. So I wanted to mimic that to this photo, so I added the white marker. I don't know if you've noticed, but Jimin's eyes is not that visible at the Dutch door, so I felt really bad about that. So I made sure that the other half of the photo, his sexy eyes would be seen this time. At the left side of the photo, I wanted to write in the month, which is June, At first, I wanted to do a fun bubble effect, but it didn't really match with my cover page anymore. So I went on to Pinterest and searched on different types of letterings, and I found this design where it's like the first coating or wrapping of the letters was being ripped off, but not in a brutal way. I was low-key still not contented with just the lettering, so I added a bit of dark shadows, stripes, and also painted the ripped part with my Koi watercolor that I've had since I was in college. I used a violet, a shade of violet, since I've been using it as an accent color since earlier. I don't know if you've noticed that, but yeah, violet is the accent color for this month. Then behind the Dutch door is where I will place the important dates for this month, since it would be quicker to look at and it won't be eating up the space for my tiny monthly spread that you will see at the next page. For my monthly spread, I'll be using a Sharpie ultra fine point in the shade of purple. The actual code for the color wasn't labeled on it, so yeah, let's just go with the it's purple color. Since it's the accent color for this month, I won't be shading all the boxes with this, since the marker bleeds. I'll be using it on a few boxes, and then using my Unipin 0.8 I'll be outlining the other boxes. I made a 5x5 boxes. Because it's the only cut that will fit everything. Now using my prang, I shaded in the boxes that I used my Sharpie marker with, since it's not that visible. It didn't came out as what I was expecting it to be. So yeah, I shaded in the boxes, and thank God it didn't bleed to the other page. And I actually like this effect, so yeah. I will then be adding drop shadows in the later while. I was supposed to only add in the drop shadows with the black boxes, but what the heck? What the hell, right? As what you've seen at the early earlier part of this video, I was cutting photos that I printed out on, well, I asked my mom to print it out. Anyways, that I got from the internet, and I have this, I saved this old magazines so that I can reuse it for journals like this one. I will be using it as an accent page, just like the ones I do with my digital journal. If you haven't seen that, I will be linking my other June bullet journal at the upper right. I also found these stickers on Pinterest. It's not mine. Kudos to the creator of these drawings. It's quite great. And I've been using it, so thank you. There was a lot of Korean stickers on Pinterest, so I just printed that out on sticker paper. Actually, I've had this sticker since last year. I've been using it on my other bullet journal. By the way, if you want to check out that bullet journal, my traveler's journal from 2018, my paper journal, since I uploaded a digital 2018 bullet journal. What am I saying? Anyways, if you want to see my traveler's journal, let me know at the comments down below. And I'll make sure to make a video on that. Here is a cute photo that of V and Jimin, and they're just so cute. I just have to insert that one in as well. Right corner, I don't know if you've noticed, there's a YouTube banner or logo at the side. It's not your usual YouTube tracker or growth tracker for YouTube, since I'm still slowly, well, my channel is still slowly growing, but I guess I'll start doing a tracker when I reach to 1,000. So please, guys, subscribe down below. Here is, for the next page, is my trackers, my habit trackers. On my digital journal, I didn't place a habit tracker. Well, I did make a habit tracker, but it's not as detailed, or it's not as plenty as this one. So yeah, I made my habit tracker is here, so that since I have this with me all the time, I can just shade it whenever I finished a task. Usually my habit trackers are on the left and my code page are on the right, but since the Sharpie markers bleed through the paper, I had to cover it. So this is why my code page, well, it won't be a code page, since I'll be writing a lyric from their song in English subtitles. On the page or the space given. Thank you. For my weekly spread, I'll be making use of the photos that I asked my mom to print out for me that I got from the internet, and well, basically just how I make my weekly spreads. It's more so that the same. So I made a lot of weekly spread ideas on my channel, so check those videos out as well if this ideas is still not okay with you guys. Ever. I still made use of the remaining pieces of the paper that from the magazine and tried to reuse it or repurpose it in the other pages. I have to cover that girl from the magazine because she doesn't, well, it might, some might think that she serves a purpose on the design, but she doesn't. So I got this post-it, well, paper. This paper from when I was a kid. It was Belle themed from Belle, the title. I'm sure everyone's screaming it. Beauty and the Beast. Yeah, it's that themed, so I've had it since forever. So I chose to add it in here because it kind of fits. Yeah, so basically the following pages will be my weekly spreads, and using all the repurposing all the remaining papers. As you can see, those are the papers from the cardboard paper that I use for my cover page. Less so, more so, just like that. So enjoy this weekly spread ideas. This next weekly spread, I just have to say, is supposedly my favorite. Not because V is here, it's just because it's pink. It's just pink, black, white. Just my aesthetic, that's all. Now, proceeding to the last page of this bullet journal. My last weekly spread. Yeah, so this is basically it for my bullet journal, and I really hope you guys liked it, and let's proceed to the flip through. Here you will be seeing me seeing that I added a few song lyrics from at the sides that I think was still missing a piece, so yeah, I'll be reading those to you guys since I didn't zoom in. So sorry about that. So in this page it says, even if you feel alone many times a day, don't throw away yourself. I regret not writing. Even if the sandy ocean floor splits in two, even if someone shakes up this world, never let go of my hand. Please don't wake up from this dream. Take my hand now. You are the cause of my euphoria. Perfect. I also add in another quote under song lyric from Spring Day, because why won't I? It reads, I wanna hold your hand and go to the other side of the earth. They're just so romantic quotes or song lyrics. Anyways, that's it for this video. I hope you guys liked it. Leave a thumbs up and click on the subscribe button down below so you'll get notified. Well, that's if you clicked on the bell. So, yeah, do that as well. Bye, guys!